I was a language lecturer, and my husband and I came here in the 80s to pursue our higher degrees.
I'm an educator. I've been doing that for 14, 15 years now.
I have two sons, and one is married, and I have a granddaughter.
And I have two beautiful children.
My son is he's a PhD student now, and his wife is a doctor.
I am from the beautiful city, Kashgar. I was born there and raised.
I saw some videos on the social media, on the Facebook, that in the city that I grew up, you know, the streets are empty. Nobody's there.
A lot of people don't know who we are, let alone what is happening in China. 20 million Uyghurs suffering.
So last year, you know, I finally gathered my courage and decided to call, because if you call, I could put them in trouble. She didn't pick up. Half an hour later, my brother, he called me and he said, you know, Dad just called and told me to let you know that never ever call your sister again. Don't call her again. And I called my sister and she didn't respond.
To this day, I don't know where my sister is. I don't know my rest of my family, what they're doing.
I don't know if any of my family members are dead or alive.
When I looked at the map, 70% of the maps were the concentration camps were located where I was from.
They persecuting Uyghur people under anti-extremist, anti-separatist, anti-terrorism.
And there are mounted evidence that they are committing genocide against Uyghurs and other minorities that never seen before since Holocaust.
You know what all this came from? It's after September 11th in the United States, the war on terror. Now they hijacked it conveniently. This is giving Chinese government a good excuse. Oh, okay, you know how easy the Muslims will be called terrorists.
To reach their goal, which is completely eradicate us, not only our religious beliefs, but our cultural identity.
Nazis did that to Jewish people in the 30s. And now, this is, at that time, the slogan was, never again.
We vowed, when Holocaust happened, never again, and yet it is happening.
They have crematory built next to the concentration camps. And they're burning them. They are just erasing the evidence.
Organ harvesting, for example. And that has been on the news with evidence. Doctors that who actually participated in the process, they testified.
There's this one girl and telling this policeman, you can do whatever you want to do to me. Please get me out of here.
And if people die, then you cannot pray. You cannot take them to masjid to do prayer and have a proper burial.
And I heard so many stories of those raping business. And they're like girls 18 to 25, they were gathered together and they just put it somewhere. It's just, it's horrendous.
And for some outsiders, they don't know how Chinese government is, how brutal they are. Maybe it's hard for them to comprehend. And they would ask, would it be possible to have a Holocaust type of genocide in China? Every minute or every hour you wait, and there are millions of people are suffering back there. And there's no indications of Chinese government slowing down.
Yeah, I just hope somebody tell me, you know, your family is, somebody died, somebody is this sick, somebody, you know, something about their situation. And now it's like a completely blank. no information, there's no way we can reach them.
I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine.
I hope they are not dead. And I pray every day that someday I'm going to meet them.
The religion is something in your heart, in your soul. It's not like somebody can just take it away. They can force you for a period of time, but I think over the time, you know, it's always in your heart, always.